Hello everyone, this is Prashant from MIT. Today I'll be presenting my work on modeling human motives and emotion from personal narratives using external knowledge and entity tracking. As we get into our work, we need to be aware of the importance of narratives. Narratives are one of the most common yet powerful means of communication. All of us share our daily stories and life experiences to our friends and families. We use stories to talk about a whole lot of issues and understanding the social world. The ubiquity of narratives has been emphasized in a number of interdisciplinary studies that has led several researchers and theorists suggest how stories play a very critical role in social awareness. Even our brain loves stories so much that psychologist Robin Davis claimed humans are primates whose cognitive capacity shuts down the absence of a story. Similarly, professor and computer scientist Patrick Winston explained how narratives are the fundamental means by which we organize and explain the world. Thus, narratives are an essential part of being aware of one's own experiences and interpreting the social world around us. Also, a famous education psychologist, Jerome Bruner, in his book Act of Meaning, described what narratives are composed of. According to him, a narrative is composed of a unique sequence of events, mental states, and happenings involving human beings as characters or actors. These are its constituents. Their meaning is given by their place in the overall configuration of the sequence as a whole. Just as we talk about the narratives and its components or the constituents, why not quickly jump into a story straight away? Like we discussed about its pervasiveness, why don't we pull up a personal story from social media, that is a story shared on Reddit. So here goes the story where the story is about a woman in tech who shares a toxic experience with a manager. So the story goes like this. I'm a woman in tech and my first 2 years were really bad because of my ex-manager. Though I've always wanted to prove my mettle. My ex-manager was fairly sexist and suggested that I'm not cut out for tech, but be a baker or an HR person. My ex-manager built up more stress and created more issues. I doubted myself and wanted to move out. It's been months since then. Somehow I got transferred to a new team to escape from the toxicity. Wow, I'm a totally supportive team and I love going into work again. I'm so grateful and happy that I stuck out, and to be promoted within few months is my revenge for him. So as I read through the story, we as humans process various actions of the narrator and the manager. We automatically understand the sequences of events that the narrator experiences. I just highlight some of them here. For example, the narrator was suggested that she wasn't cut out for tech and probably could become a baker, right? So this is one of the highlighted texts here. Similarly, when I read the story, we all could understand what the narrator exactly wants and her feelings. Some of these are explicitly mentioned, like she wanted to escape from toxicity and got transferred to a new team. And she feels happy as an outcome of shifting to a new team. These are explicitly stated motives or emotional reactions. But are these the only motives or emotions that the character undergo in the story? Not really, right? Beyond what was explicitly mentioned, we can also infer implicit mental states of people. In this case, we could identify the motives or the emotions of the manager as well as the narrator based on what is being expressed in the narrative. For example, the manager builds up more stress. Probably he wants to have more control or make things worse for her so that he can exercise his power and feel satisfied about it. The human intelligence keeps track of all these different interactions in social situations and represents the mental states of various participants based on their actions. Such intuitive inferences are instantaneous for humans to process. And this cognitive capability to infer and represent one's own and other people's mental state is referred to as mentalizing. Such mentalizing abilities are critical for humans to make sense of the social world, but it is really super hard for machines to draw these inferences on the fly instantaneously. In this work, we investigate the methods to automatically embed, infer, and generate textual explanations of mental states of characters in stories. However, it is important to figure out the key challenges in this process. There exist both data and modeling challenges. For example, regarding the data set, there is a lack of proper mechanism to obtain explicit and implicit mental states from stories in natural settings. That is, stories from social media, as an example. With variable length texts, or even varying number of characters in each story. In terms of the modeling challenge, there is a limited work that focuses on tracking entities, or that is the characters in our case, and specifically dynamic tracking of mental state is really crucial to our work. Further, we focus on effectively embedding and generating textual explanations, conditioning on the prior story context and mental states. So in order to address the data challenge, what we do is that we depend on personal stories from Reddit analogous to our working example. Personal stories are known to be brief, diverse, and great source of common sense causal information centered around social and mental topics rather than natural and physical causality. So while news stories, histories, or movies have mass of individuals, personal stories usually contain few characters told from protagonist's point of view. Our data collection pipeline is depicted in the figure below. More details on how we collect data and individual steps can be referred to in our paper. We aggregate two data sets primarily, a weekly annotated personal narrative corpus and search-based social common sense knowledge. So first we begin with the personal narrative corpus, which is intended to capture the motives and emotions explicitly mentioned considering the entire story context. These are actually mentioned by the narrator themselves in the stories. We actually apply information extraction methods by feeding sentences to OpenAI tools. We actually derive purpose clauses as one can refer to the image on the right, where it takes the form in order plus to infinitive in this case. We identify the agent and also the motivation expression from such extractions. Similarly, we use FrameNet-based lexical units to collect emotional reaction expressions. Further, we augment data using paraphrases from back translation. You can actually refer to the table below to see some of the examples from the dataset, as well as the dataset statistics on the right. One of the limitations of the personal narrative corpus is that it may not contain implicit mental state mappings for several events in the narrative. To alleviate this limitation, we collect sentence-level implicit mental states by adopting a combination of web data mining and information extraction strategies. We adopt a similar method for information extraction, but additionally, we use web search-based techniques to obtain possible intents and emotions which are actually inherent in the sentence itself. For example, a sample from the data set can be seen on the right. Say politicians use social media to either woo voters, and probably activists use social media to create a movement or create awareness. So it's going to be the same event phrase that's going to be use social media, but depending on the social role information, the motive changes. Since we have collected the data sets right now, we directly get into the modeling aspect of it. So why not begin with the simplest encoder decoder model using a transformer encoder and a transformer based autoregressive decoder. So what we do is that we just pass the sentences individually from the narrative and then obtain the explanations of intents and reactions from the decoder. So what we find is that the decoder emits intents that are directly part of the input text or sometimes produces inappropriate results too. For example, see the intent generated by this model for one of the sentences in the narrative. For example, my manager was fairly sexist and suggested that I'm not cut out for tech, but be a baker or HR person, right? So the narrator intent supposedly generated by the model is to be a baker, which is inappropriate. The narrator doesn't want to be a baker, but she was told to be a baker by the manager. It's kind of a sexist comment to make. So we don't really want this kind of results. So processing stories without context can be really problematic is what we find. Now, in this knowledge encoder or decoder, we make two modifications. First one is to include context into place represented by S less than T in addition to the current sentence, ST, and entity given by EJ in the diagram. And the other modification is the knowledge enrichment module that produces pragmatic enrichment of sentences. We utilize a recent work, which is called Event BERT model, as it is cited below, for this component. We feed the mental state attribute M, and the which is going to be either intent or the reactions, and current story sentence as our input, and get kind of pragmatic aware embedding as output of this module. This module, which is called knowledge enrichment module, can be viewed akin to a semantic memory Generally, semantic memory refers to long-term storehouse of general knowledge related to events, facts, or concepts. So what we see on the right is the part of the encoder where the context information is incorporated through the transform attention layer. And then we also incorporate the knowledge enrichment part through the highlighted part of the encoder, where we feed the current sentence and obtain representation from that module and combine it with the output from the context incorporated representation. This pretty much forms the encoding component. So on the right, you can view the resulting sequence of generated intents related to the sentences in the narrative. As one can observe, there's a significant improvement with the generation. For example, for the same sentence where the manager was making a sexist comment, we show that the model guesses the narrator's intent is to get away or to be treated with respect, thankfully not repeating the same sexist statement. However, the model tends to get repetitive over a period of time or even get confused when there are multiple entities for which we need to make inferences of the metastates. So in order to counter these aspects, we draw ideas from human cognitive behaviors and employ entity-based memory module and a deliberation decoder. The entity-based memory module can be seen as an episodic memory that ideally stores and tracks mental states of characters as we process different sentences in the narrative. Regarding the deliberation decoding, it is implemented as two-pass iterative decoding strategy. You can see the decoding component consisting of two phases here. Now, in the first phase, we combine the context and the knowledge information again, and it generates a rough draft of explanations. In the second phase, we utilize the information from the prior generated mental states stored in the entity memory module. This particular module is used to dynamically track the prior mental states of characters in the narrative so that the generated explanations are coherent to the prior events in the narrative. We use memory attention to incorporate that information to produce subsequent mental state generations and polish a rough graph to produce better decoded output. So one can actually see the highlighted part of the text below. Let's take an example of the last two sentences here. The complete model explains how the narrator wants to prove a point after getting her promotion, whereas the older model produces much more generic intents. So once you're done with the modeling, let's get into the evaluation setup. We run experiments on the manually annotated gold explanations of sample data from our own personal narrative corpus. And then we also evaluate on a benchmark character psychology data set, which actually contains rich low-level annotations of both categories, state categories, and textual explanations of motivation and emotional reactions of characters in 5-sentence stories, which is much more an artificial setting. So for the explanation generation results, what we find is that we explored prior models also that use entity-based memory or transformer-based language models as our baselines. The entity-based models in these prior work, however, was limited to tracking entity references or even recognizing entity state similarity or predicting simple attributes from entity states. Our work, however, provides a more comprehensive mechanism to actually track the emotional reactions and the motivations of characters and stories. What we observe is that our model achieves an absolute improvement of approximately 8% to 11% over a fine-tuned GPT-2 model on embedding average metric. Also, on a state classification task, we did compare against the baselines already mentioned, but in addition to that, we also taken like state-of-the-art models that specifically model for either motives or emotions only, using either multi-hop knowledge or the label semantics that track label-to-label correlation for emotional reference. So the key takeaway is that our models outperform the state-of-the-art method significantly for both motivation and emotional reactions using our method. We do compare the importance of the critical modules, basically the knowledge enrichment module or the entity state module by running the narration study. And what we find is that there is a dip in performance on intent generation, which is more pronounced when knowledge enrichment module is removed, while the entity memory module is critical for improved performance on emotion generation tasks. Thus, we find that a model is able to learn effectively to embed and generate motives and emotional reactions from personal stories. We also explore if the representations learned from a model can be transferred to a downstream task. We find that there is a wonderful scope for applying it in narratives extracted from other domains with limited training data, that is low resource regimes. Also, they can be leveraged for empathetic dialogue generation. In future, we could also explore its utility in narrative comprehension, for example, towards modeling narrative structures using protagonists' mental state representations. These are some of the ways in which these embeddings can be used, and this opens up several other domains where such knowledge can be utilized effectively. So here is my contact information and project page as well. The data and the code will be released and updated in the future on this page. Thank you so much for listening.